We have a trapezoid here. That means two of the sides are parallel. And we're looking for a method for finding the area of a trapezoid. No. I got this, Harvey. I got this. Now, I know what we did in those other shapes. We did something really clever. We rearranged the shape somehow and turned it into something we already knew how to find the area of. So we're going to do the same thing here. I just have to find it. There's something hidden here. Let's see. Ha! Ha! Found it, Harvey. You had two trapezoids in there. I told you I got this. Uh-oh. No, I guess I don't got this. All right, help me out. Oh, come on, Harvey, help me out. All right, I'll say it. Harvey is the smartest. Now, come on, help me. Flip it. Okay, which way? Horizontally or vertically? Both? All right, I'll flip them both. Flip it horizontally. Then I'll flip it vertically. There we go. We got our second trapezoid. We flipped it twice. Now, oh, I see it now. Yeah, you are the smartest. All right. This is really awesome. So these two trapezoids are the same. They're identical. This is the same as this, right? Because we took this, we flipped it over, we flipped it down. These two sides are the same, so we can put them together. But watch what happens with these two angles. Right now, in this trapezoid, these two sides are parallel. That means this plus this is 180 degrees. But we made this trapezoid by taking this one and flipping it over this way, and then flipping it down, so this angle came to here. These two angles add to 180, so this angle plus this angle adds to 180. So when we put these two sides together, the two angles that we're putting together add to 180. And that means this comes out to be a straight line. Same thing's going on up here. We got a straight line up there. Now take a look at these two sides here. Looks like they're parallel, right? And we can prove that too. These two angles add up to 180 degrees. When we flip this trapezoid around to make this one, this angle is the same as that angle. These two angles are the same. These two angles add up to be 180 degrees because these two sides are parallel. That means these two angles have to add up to 180 degrees. That tells us that these two sides are parallel as well. This is a parallelogram, and we know how to find the area of a parallelogram. We just take the height here, call that the height, and we multiply by the length of the base. Now let's see, how are we going to express the length of this base in terms of our trapezoid? We'll say at the top part here, this piece up here, we'll call that A. We'll call this piece down here, we'll call that B. So now when we flip this trapezoid around, this down here is also A, this up here is B. So the area of the whole parallelogram is our whole base times our height. So that's H times A plus B. But for the trapezoid, there's two trapezoids here. So our whole parallelogram is two trapezoids. So the area of the trapezoid is just half the area of the parallelogram. So the area of the trapezoid is the height times the sum of the two parallel sides, sum of those lengths, divided by two. Yeah, you're the smartest. All right, you win. All right, one more problem. Got one more problem? Make sure we know how to use this. And plus, you can kind of help me out here. So I've got this trapezoidal field at my house, and I need to go get some seed to plant my field. Now, of course, they don't have the bags just set there. Here's one for this size. Here's one, you know, here's one for this shape. The bags are based on the area of your field. They'll say, you know, this covers so many square yards. So I need to figure out the area of my field. Now, here are the dimensions of my field. I went out and measured it. I don't really have a tool to just measure area, but I can measure these lengths. And, well, these two are right angles. That means this plus this is 180 degrees. These two sides are parallel. My field's a trapezoid, so I can use this formula back here to find the area. But I don't have the height. All I have are the two parallel sides, the lengths of the two parallel sides. So, you know what? I'm going to try out, it's one of my favorite strategies, build right triangles. It's one of my favorite strategies with trapezoids, because trapezoids are confusing, but rectangles and right triangles, those are easy. And when I draw an altitude in here to make a right triangle, I'm also making a rectangle. This is a rectangle over here. Rectangles, right triangles, these are way easier than trapezoids. Now let's see, this is a rectangle, so this is 55. That means this side is 55 as well. And this whole thing is 85, so this little piece down here is 30. And now I see in this right triangle, I got 30, I got 50, that means this other leg has to be 40. Use the Pythagorean theorem, we can just see we got a 3, 4, 5 right triangle. Now we've got our height, now we can find our area. Now we could just go ahead and add the areas of these two pieces. Hey, you know what, Harvey? I'll bet we could have proved the area formula for the trapezoid by doing this. Cutting into right triangles and rectangles. You check that out later. But here, instead of just finding the areas of the two pieces separately, we can come back here now and use our handy formula for the area of a trapezoid. And we can crank this right out. We got the two sides, we've got our height, so our area is 40 times the sum 55 plus 85, and all of that divided by 2. 55 plus 85, that's 140. 140 divided by 2 is 70. 70 times 40 is 2,800 square yards. And we are done.